In this video, we'll see the modes of operation of timer. So there are total four modes of operation of timer, that is mode 0, mode 1, mode 2 and mode 3. So first mode, that is mode 0, is a 13-bit timer counter mode, and mode 1 is a 16-bit timer counter mode, then mode 2 is 8-bit auto reload mode, and finally mode 3 is 2 8-bit timers, and this mode is available only for timer 0. And for timer 1, first three modes are available. So we'll start with the mode 0. So this mode 0 is a 13-bit timer counter mode. In this, we have two timer registers, that is TL0 and TH0. So here, this TL0 has only 5 lower bits, whereas this register is actually of 8 bits, but out of those 8 bits, only lower 5 bits are taken for counting. Then TH0 register is also of 8 bits. So this entire register is used for counting. So we can load any 5-bit value in TL0 register. So that acts as a divide by 32 counter. So whenever 32 clock pulses are given, then this block will give one clock pulse to the next block, that is TH0, assuming that the initial value here is all zeros. So we can load any 5-bit value, and from that 5-bit value onwards, the counting will start. So whenever the value in TL0 reaches maximum limit, that is all 5 bits become 1, and if one more clock pulse is given, the value in TL0 becomes 0 and the value in TH0 is incremented by 1. So in this way, this mode 0 works. And whenever finally the TH0 reaches its maximum value, that is FF hex, at that time, if one more clock pulse is given to TH0, then TH0 overflows. That is, the value present in TH0 rolls back to 00 from FF. And at the same time, the timer 0 overflow flag, that is TF0, is made equal to 1 to indicate that overflow has occurred. And this can be used for generating the timer 0 interrupt. So same thing is available for timer 1 as well. So this is the basic working of mode 0. Next mode is mode 1, that is a 16-bit timer counter mode. In this, again, the entire 8 bits of TL0 and entire 8 bits of TH0 are used for counting. So the maximum value of TL0 is FF and maximum value of TH0 is also FF. So the total maximum value of timer 0 in mode 1 will be FF FF hex, and on every clock pulse, the value in TL0 will be incremented by 1. So when TL0 value becomes FF, this will roll back again to 00, and at that time, this TH0 will be incremented by 1, and so on. So whenever both the resistors have value FF FF and one more clock pulse is given, then both the resistors will roll back to the value 0000 hex. And at the same time, the timer 0 overflow flag TF0 is set to 1 to indicate that overflow has occurred. And this can be used for generating the timer 0 interrupt. So same thing is available for timer 1 as well. Instead of 0, here we have 1 for timer 1. Next mode is mode 2, that is 8-bit auto reload mode. Now in this mode, the value present in TL0 is incremented by 1 on every clock pulse. And whenever the value of TL0 overflows, that is whenever it is having value FF, and if one more clock pulse is given, at that time TL0 will overflow. So at that time, the timer 0 overflow flag will be set to 1 to indicate that TL0 has overflowed. And at the same time, a signal is given to this tri-state buffer. So this buffer becomes active, and the value which is present in TH0, that value is copied to TL0 register. And from next clock pulse onwards, the value in TL0 keeps on incrementing on every clock pulse. So suppose if the value present in TH0 is 20 hex, so that value will be loaded to TL0. And the counting will start from 20 hex onwards. So it will reach to FF, and after FF, it will again roll back to 20. and not 0, because this is the speciality of auto reload mode. So whatever value is present in TH0, that is the initial counting value of TL0. So TL0 will start counting from that value up to FF. So again, whenever TL0 overflows, TF0 flag indicates the overflow, and this can be used for generating the interrupt. So this is the mode 2, that is 8-bit auto reload mode. So this mode is generally used for generating a baud rate in case of a serial communication. And finally, we have mode 3, which is 2 8-bit timers. This mode is available only for timer 0. So first 3 modes are available for timer 1 as well, but this mode 3 is available only for timer 0. So in this case, the timer is split into 2 parts. So as we know that we have 2 resistors, that is TH0 and TL0. So these resistors are split into 2 parts. So lower part, that is TL0 resistor, is having a overflow flag as TF0, and TH0, that is upper part of timer 0, is having the overflow flag as TF1. This flag is actually used by timer 1, but in this mode this is used by timer 0. So both the timers can be operated separately. So to start this timer, we have to use TR0 bit for TL0 timer, whereas for starting the TH0 timer, we have to use TR1 bit for starting the timer. So whenever TH0 overflows, that is the value in TH0 becomes FF, and if one more clock pulse is given, it will roll back to 0. At the same time, this TF1 flag will be made equal to 1 to indicate that overflow has occurred, and this can be used for generating the timer 1 interrupt. Then same is the case with TL0. So if it is having value FF, and if one more clock pulse is given, the value in TL0 goes from FF to 0, and at the same time TF0 flag is made equal to 1 to indicate that overflow has occurred, and this can be used for generating the timer 0 interrupt. So these are the modes that are available in timer 0. So as per our requirement, you can choose the proper mode for your application. In the next video, we'll see the serial communication peripheral, that is a serial port present in 8051. For more information, you can log on to the website given in the description of this video. Thank you.